welcome back to ANG DIY on Wednesdays, 10 a.m. But if you can't remember that, don't worry about it. All you have to do is subscribe and hit the bell, and then you will get email notifications every week when a new episode is posted. So this week we are finally tackling a new larger project. What we're gonna do is create a headboard because I was super against buying a headboard as they are $150 to $200, and that is just way too much money in my opinion. But I just figured that it would be easy enough to create. So what I did is I took a look on Pinterest and I actually saw inspiration to do something a little bit different. I don't know if you guys have seen, it's a really big trend right now in like interior design and DIY, all this stuff. People painting arches on their wall, which is super cute. I really like the look, but of course in a rented apartment, I cannot do any painting. So this inspired me though to do a arch design for the headboard that would have kind of the effect of a painted headboard, and then I would just throw that up and it would kind of look painted, but it would also serve the purpose of the headboard with the foam padding. Instead of purchasing fabric, I went to my local Target, as I do frequently, and I got a sheet set, one of the like college dorm twin XL sheets, and I got a package that had a large flat sheet that was in the color that I wanted, and then I used that and hot glue to upholster this headboard. So it came out really cool. I really like it, and I hope that it's easy enough for you guys to follow along. And yeah, let's take a look at how it came together.
First, I measured the approximate size for the headboard and cut the cardboard boxes to that size. Next, I taped together the pieces. Using string, I trace a half circle, like a protractor, giving myself a few inches of the non-rounded edge at the bottom. Using good scissors, I cut the cardboard along the lines into the half moon shape. Next, I take the foam pads and use hot glue to attach them to the cardboard. I didn't go crazy with the glue, using just enough to create a strong adhesive, but not going overboard. I cut away the extra foam along the rounded edges of the headboard, and I used the discarded pieces on another section of the board. This continues as I break into the second pack of foam, and cutting along the edges to create the arch shape. Then I take my flat sheet and wrap it around the arch, cutting away any extra pieces and pulling so that the fabric is snug, but not so tight that the cardboard bends, as I secure it with the hot glue. And that's it.
So what I have here is my massive headboard. As you can see, we got the cardboard, we got the hot glued edges because, you know, we're making it work. It's not perfect, but it doesn't need to be, it's cheap. And then we have the foam padding, nice and squishy, and ta-da! So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get this up on the wall and we will see how it looks. So I think it looks fantastic. I am so happy with the result, and I think it brings in a nice color to the room too, because right now everything is very white and gray, which I mean was my intention, but I did want to have some blue in there as well, and this without me spending $1 million on Marshall pillows with blue in them. Now I have that introduction of the color, and you know, it serves the purpose of a headboard too. So I think for how cheap it was, which let's do the math, cardboard was essentially free. Don't check my bank account, but the cardboard box is free. And then the sheet set was $8. The foam were $6 a piece. I did buy two, so that's 12, 20 bucks. Yeah, and then hot glue, which I'm still working on the same pack that I got for $1 from the dollar store months ago. So let's just say this project came to $20 for a large really cool looking headboard instead of paying $200 for one that I didn't even like. So it was super cheap, super easy. I did it all in one night. So if you are lucky enough to be going back to college, this is the perfect DIY to try out on a board night in. Which of course, if you do try it out, please show me, tag me, comment. I definitely want to see what you guys come up with. So thank you so much. Please like, please subscribe, please comment, please share, please tell your friends, watch, and I will see you guys next week.